Now that we've covered the basics of containerization in general, let's discuss Docker. Docker is an abstraction built on top of lower-level container technologies, such as libvirt or LXC. Docker provides a simple command line interface as well as an HTTP API interface to create and publish container images and to run containers themselves. Docker provides a way to package an application and all of its system dependencies into a standardized unit. The standardized packaging is a Docker image, which is a layered, immutable approach to creating images. We'll spend a whole chapter in this course just talking about Docker images. Docker is a tool, but it also encompasses an ecosystem of other tools and services, such as Docker Hub, a central repository used to host publicly shared Docker images. Docker has grown to be widely used as a deployment mechanism for applications because of the guarantee that an image will always run the same, regardless of the environment. This gives developers parity across dev, test, and production. The phrase, "it works on my machine," is no longer valid. Docker has a number of components. Although it might not seem like it when you run Docker on a Linux machine, it is actually a client-server application. The Docker binary does not interact with containers or images directly. The Docker binary simply accepts command line calls, such as the two seen here, and sends the instructions to the Docker daemon via HTTP or via TCP socket. If both components are on the same host machine, this communication mechanism is also used. The Docker host is the server-side component of Docker Engine. The Docker host houses the Docker daemon, which is the process that actually interacts with Docker images and containers. The Docker host also houses the containers and Docker images themselves. The Docker host exposes an HTTP API that can be used by other programs to manage containers and images. The final component required to work with Docker is a Docker registry. A Docker registry is a remote service that centrally houses published Docker images. The official Docker registry is called Docker Hub and is managed directly by Docker. We can see in the diagram a number of real images that are actually hosted in Docker Hub on the right. Docker Hub houses thousands of pre-built Docker images contributed by third-party vendors, individual developers, and Docker themselves. Most common applications, programming language runtimes, and databases have official Docker Hub images available. Running a MySQL database on your Docker host is as easy as the command docker run MySQL. In this case, the client will make an API call to the Docker HTTP API endpoint for creating containers. This will trigger the Docker daemon to pull the latest Docker image for MySQL from Docker Hub and create a running container from it on the Docker host. All container and image operations are managed this way. In the next few chapters, we'll cover the basic commands for managing containers and images. Another component in the Docker ecosystem is Docker Machine. Docker Machine is a command line tool that can be used to create and manage Docker hosts. Docker Machine allows non-Linux users to run the Docker client locally on their local host and issue Docker commands to a remote virtual machine, be it running in a local hypervisor or in a cloud provider. An example of what Docker Machine can do is the Docker Machine create command, which will create a fresh new Docker host named dev that can be controlled using your local Docker client. To use our new Docker host named dev, we can use the Docker machine to set the appropriate environment variables to point the local client at the new machine, and then we can begin issuing commands. Another useful component in the Docker ecosystem is Docker Swarm, which is a clustering tool that allows us to manage a group of Docker hosts as if it were a single Docker host. Docker Swarm publishes an API almost identical to the normal Docker API, which means that most tooling is compatible. We can use the Docker client to run containers with Docker Swarm and easily scale out to multiple hosts. Sometimes we'd like to containerize an application with multiple components, including databases or other services. Using the component Docker Compose, we can specify a group of containers and wire them together. The diagram shows an example Docker Compose YAML file that will start a group of containers running MongoDB, RabbitMQ, and a Python web application. Running Docker Compose with this configuration will produce three containers running these applications that are networked together. Docker Compose is a great tool for development environments and deploying multi-container applications. There's a lot of tools in the Docker ecosystem, and we're going to cover each of them throughout this course.